What's up, Union students?
It's Union Night.
Let's go.
Yo, Izzy, it's the first Union Night of the year.
That's crazy. First Union Night of 2021. Isn't that, that's something.
It's something, but the snow didn't stop us.
Look, we just had to hit a little switch up on y'all. You know what I'm saying?
You can't just switch it.
Expect the unexpected. That's all I gotta say.
Absolutely. Yeah, so we are live in our YouTube channel, so type it up in the chat. Shout out Izzy. Shout out Pastor Devontae when he delivers his message. And we are so happy you're here. And if this is your first time checking out Union Night, you don't know what it is. Well, it's our middle and high schoolers of I-5 City. And on behalf of our lead pastors, Pastor Jimmy and Irene Rollins, we want to welcome you. We want to say, hey, thanks for watching. Thanks for tuning in. And just text I-5VIP if this is your first time to 97,000. And Izzy, two things are going to happen.
Yes. So somebody's going to reach out to you and make sure that you're getting connected with the people that you need to be connected to. You know, you got to come in the house. You got to come in the house. You got to be welcomed home. What else?
Yep. And so also we're going to give you some next steps in your relationship with God.
Yes.
Yeah, and speaking of getting connected, next Sunday, we're launching our student groups.
I don't think you got excited enough for that, Nicole.
You're the groups guy.
Next Sunday, we launch student groups!
Student groups, yes!
Let's go!
So look, for middle and high schoolers, this is your way to make friends, get connected to other students that don't even go to your school.
Yes, this is the perfect way to get around people your age and your age group. You know, sometimes you can't relate to people that's that much younger than you.
You know,
because
I'm 30 and
Yeah, you need a separate student group, or city group. You're
adult,
not a student no more.
Adult group.
Yeah, that thing. But look, we launch next Sunday. Make sure you text I-5 groups to 97,000. You might as well just save it as a contact in your phone at this point. But text I-5 groups to 97,000 to get connected.
Yeah, and it's super easy. A link's gonna go to your phone and you can find your age group and your grade and then sign up for that group.
Sign up for your group. You can't be in quarantine alone. You know what I'm saying?
You know? Hey, Izzy, something at Union we love to do.
Shoes?
We love shoes, but we love giveaways even more.
Oh, yeah, that too. Yeah.
So we are actually giving away $500 tonight.
Woo!
For Union Night for the first one of the year. And two people are going to win
$250. $250,
that's
a pair of shoes.
Clothes.
Maybe some bills.
Some Starbucks, some food.
You know,
I could do a lot with $250.
$250 at Starbucks?
Like I want clothes, shoes, Starbucks, food, like all of it.
Oh, wow. Okay, yeah. That works too.
So Izzy, how can these students win?
So look, again, save it as a contact in your phone. Text We Are Union to 97,000 and you will automatically be entered in for this giveaway, all right? First two people that text We Are Union
so do
to
it 97,000. We're
do
live.
It right now. If you want that $250, you seen them?
You better
Yeezys?
Go. You
seen
them? Text that number?
You need them. You need them. Go ahead. Just get them. They be on the house.
All right, guys, let's get tonight started. We're going to start off with some worship. And it's going to be a little crazy.
It's going to be so crazy, you might even say it might be wild.
A little wild.
Uh-oh.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Hey, Union, come and party with us. Let's turn up one time. Let's go. Woo!
Above all distractions, above every doubt, you have my attention here right now. Love from the outset, yours from the start. You broke through the darkness to have my heart. I'm lost to the world, in you forever found. In a love that never fades, in a hope that never sways. You'll never let go, this love is wild, wild. You got me reaching for the sky, now I'm standing hope grown wild. You'll never let go, this love is wild, wild. Let's go, come on. Wild, wild. You'll catch on to it. It's real easy. We're breaking through the silence, heavenly sound, louder than thunder, shaking the ground. Where fear comes to find me, I will be found.
love that never fades, and a hope that never sways. You'll never let go. This love is wild, wild. You got me reaching for the sky. Now I'm standing hope on wild. You'll never let go. This love is wild, wild. This love is wild, wild. You got it now, sing it with us. This love is wild, wild. We about to go crazy. Oh, we about to go crazy. Shut up, shut up, shut up.
I'm Richard Ohm, and this is Silent Library.
Contestants have to shuffle the cards. If you get a safe, then you're safe. If you get the skull and crossbones, then you have to complete the challenge. Round one. Clean the dishes, and remember, silence.
I can't do it!
The contestants lost round one. Juan failed to clean the dishes. Round two, art attack. Remember, silence. Thank you. The contestants won round two. Izzy was able to withstand the pain. Round three, wine taste test. Remember, silence. Close, but not close enough. Izzy wasn't able to complete the challenge. Last round, eat cake. And remember, silence. Round 4. Although they were able to complete the challenge, they were too loud.
Union students, how are you doing? I hope you're staying warm. The snow made it so that we couldn't meet in person, but I just want to let you know I love you so much. I hope that you are enjoying your time at home. And hey, for those of you who are going back to school, this just means you got snow days now. So hey, you get to stay home even longer. It's amazing. We love you so much here at Union Students, and your safety is our number one priority. So unfortunately, we couldn't meet together tonight, but we want to let you know that we love you so much. Everyone here from I-5 City, the Union team, we love you with everything that we are. And I'm excited for tonight. If you're joining us, tonight is quiet. It's a weird word, quiet. Why do we choose quiet to start off the year? I just think God wants to say some things to us this year, but we're going to have to be quiet in order to hear them. And so I'm excited for tonight. I'm excited for this word. But hey, I heard that we're giving away $250 tonight. I don't know about you, but I could use $250 in my life. So I want to encourage you, if you haven't already, make sure you text We Are Union to 97000. Make sure you submit the information so that you can be signed up, put in the drawing for $250. I'm so excited to be with you. My name is Devonte. If you don't know who I am, I have the privilege of, you know, being the leader of this crazy thing, a crazy group of students who just believe that we can change the world. We are all about people knowing Jesus and then seeing him made known in the world. So I'm excited to be with you on behalf of our pastors, Pastor Jimmy and Irene Rollins from I-5 City. We love you guys. I'm going to jump into today's message, and I'm going to read out of the book of 1 Kings, chapter 19, verses 11 through 12. It says this: The Lord said, "Go and stand on the mountain in the presence of the Lord, for the Lord is about to pass by." Then a great and powerful wind tore the mountains apart and shattered the rocks before the Lord. But the Lord was not in the wind. After the wind, there was an earthquake, but the Lord was not in the earthquake. And after the earthquake came a fire, but the Lord was not in the fire. And after the fire came a gentle whisper. God, we thank you so much for who you are. We thank you that you are speaking to us. I pray tonight as we come together to learn more about you, that you would meet us where we're at, regardless of whether we can meet in person or we meet online. We know that you are speaking to us. So we love you so much. In your name we pray. Amen. Amen and amen. Thank you, Skip. You make me sound so cool. I wish he would just travel with me everywhere I go, just play under me for every moment of my life. Can you imagine like grocery shopping and you're just like, din, 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 din. Oh, they cut his keyboard off so he can't do it anymore. But hey, if I had that, it would be amazing. If you're taking notes, which I encourage you to take notes, because we believe this at Union Students, that note takers, I almost said it wrong, note takers are world changers. The title of the message is How to Hear. How to Hear. We can put that in the chat. You can type that in there, write it down in your journal, whatever it may be. How to Hear. Now, I don't know about you guys growing up in school, but I had some best friends. You guys have some best friends, like people you really love. They're like your go-to in math class and English class and science. You always sat together in the same pod. Well, I don't know about you guys, but I was bad in school. I always talk at the parent-teacher conferences. This may sound like you. They would always say, he's a pleasure to have in class. But he's always talking. He's always talking. So what they would do is they would try and separate us, me and my friends, from each other. You know, they put one of us up in the front in the corner, which was always me, so the teacher could keep an eye on me. Then put a couple people in the back, and they would kind of spread us around. And she would say, you have to stay quiet. Stop talking to your friends, my teachers. And I don't know about you guys if you have some friends like that, but isn't it crazy how when you have to stay quiet in class, that's when things become the funniest? It's like in the moment where I can't laugh, it makes me want to laugh more. I don't know if you guys were watching the Silent Library clip that we just had. I was rolling, not just because the things were funny, but because I couldn't laugh or else we would lose the game. And so I just feel like things, when you can't laugh out loud or funny, or maybe when your sibling is getting whooped, y'all got siblings who get whooped, y'all get spanked or whatever. I don't know. My parents spanked me and that made me who I am today. But if your parent spanks you and you're sitting in the corner and you start giggling, and then they look over at you, don't laugh, you're next. And it's like, oh my God, oh my gosh, I'm not supposed to laugh right now. But it's so funny to see your sibling get a whooping because it's not you getting the whooping. It's so interesting to me that when you have to be quiet, things become funnier. And I think it's because of this. Whenever you have to be quiet about laughing, it's not the loud joke, it's not the punchline that makes you laugh. It's like their facial expressions. It's the little details. It's the little things that are like, oh my gosh, look at his face grimace when my dad hits him with the belt. Oh my gosh, I really want to laugh at what my friend's doing right now, but I can't because the teacher said be quiet. But look at his face. He's looking at the girl I like. He's looking at the guy I like, and they're laughing. You're giggling, but you have to be quiet to do it. And it's because you have to focus on the details when things are quiet. And what I love about this passage of scripture that we read is this guy named Elijah, and he's a prophet, and, you know, he tells the people what God is saying. He's teaching people. He's a prophet. And it comes to this point where, you know, people are no longer following the commandments that God had in the Old Testament. And so it gets to the point where they're killing off all of these prophets. And so he has to run away. And so we see Elijah in 1 Kings. He's on the run. And when he's on the run, an angel of the Lord comes to him, and he's like, hey, here's some food. Like, dude's literally asleep, taps him up and says, hey, here's some cake. I kid you not, he was given cake. Read your Bible. Cake is in the Bible. Funfetti cake is in the Bible. And it is from God. Funfetti. If you didn't know, go buy it at the store right now. It's amazing. Gives him cake, says, hey, you're going to go to this cave. And the angel's like, what's going on? He said, yo, people are trying to kill me. Like, I got to get out of there. I'm about to die. I had to leave. I don't know what's going on. And so he's in this cave, and then the angel tells him, hey, go to the front of the cave because the presence of the Lord is about to pass by. And so what I find so interesting about this story is that when he's looking for the presence of God, it's not in the fire, it's not in the earthquake, it's not in the wind, but it's in this little whisper that comes after all of those things have passed by. And what it leads me to think, or what it leads me to believe, is that we have to focus on the still, quiet voice and not just the loud things around us. You see, what happens is we live in a world that's so loud, and we think that we have to be the loudest. We think that we have to be the best. We think we have to be the person that everybody knows in order to be known, or in order to be seen, or in order to be heard. We have to be loud. But I would submit to you this, that in order to hear the voice of God, you actually have to be quiet. You have to wait for the things that are trying to distract you, so that you can hear the thing that's trying to whisper to you. And so I'm excited for today, because some of you may be, you know, looking, and you may be like, well, okay, that's cool, but how do I even hear the voice of God? What does that even look like? I've never heard the voice of God. Can I tell you this, just to ease your mind right now? Hearing the voice of God is not always just an audible voice that is speaking to you, although that may happen. I don't know. It hasn't happened to me. I'm still waiting for it. If God says, hey, Devontae, move to Hawaii, and it's an audible voice, I'm moving to Hawaii. I might even do that just because I want to move to Hawaii. Who knows? But sometimes it's just like a thought that you wouldn't think yourself. It's a It's a still small voice. It's that thing that's like, I wouldn't normally think that. But if you're like, I don't know how to hear the voice of God, I want to give you three thoughts today that I think can help us hear the voice of God. The first one is this: prayer, 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 prayer. In 1 Kings 19, it says, 19 verse 4, it says this: while he himself went a day's journey into the wilderness, he being Elijah, he came to a broom bush. I don't know what a broom bush is. I know it's not a broom that's planted in the ground. I just know that. I don't know what a broom bush looks like. He came to a broom bush, sat down under it, and prayed. And he prayed. So what's so interesting to me about Elijah is a prophet, which means he literally hears what God is trying to speak to the people. But for some reason, he understands that if I want to hear the voice of God right now, I have to pray first. Now, I don't know if you're like me. When I was younger and I liked a girl, I really liked a girl, or maybe she even liked me, I wouldn't be the first one to initiate conversation. I know some of you guys may do this yourself right now. Instead of initiating conversation, you go to the mall with your mom and you get a new outfit. And I walk back into school, I'm like, yeah, she's gonna notice me today. Look at this girl, I'm light skinned, I'm 4'11". What's up, girl? I weigh 80 pounds. You see these new J's I got on? We were poor, so it was Team Jordan, so I didn't really want her to look at my feet, but if you know what a Team Jordan is, you know what I'm talking about. And what's so interesting to me is I thought that wearing something different was going to be the thing that initiated the conversation. But how many of you know, regardless of whether she liked me a whole lot or I liked her a whole lot, someone has to start the conversation. Someone has to be the one to initiate. Someone has to be the first one to say, hey, dot, dot, dot. And put the little monkey emojis, you know, the monkey emoji I'm talking about, like this. I know y'all use them. All y'all girls are guilty of it. I know, because my wife did it on me, and that's what got me. I said, oh, she sent me the monkey emojis. Ah! But I had to text my wife first in order to start a relationship and a conversation with her. What's so interesting to me is oftentimes when I find myself trying to hear the voice of God, I forget that in order to hear the voice of God, I first have to have a conversation going with him. And what's so amazing about this relationship that we have with God is it's like, he loves us so much, but he doesn't force us into conversation with him. So it's like he's sitting up at his phone late at night with his phone, just waiting for a notification to come through. I says, God, I don't know what to do right now. God, I'm scared. God, I don't understand. I don't even know what prayer is. They just said, if I talk to you and I pray to you, then maybe I can hear the voice of God. And so what I love is that Elijah is a prophet, but he understands if I need to hear God speak, if I want to hear the voice of God for my life, I have to initiate a conversation with him. So step one, if we want to hear the voice of God, we have to pray. Step two, posture. Posture. It says this in 1 Kings 19:11, A. This is A and B. The Lord said, go out and stand on the mountain in the presence of the Lord, for the Lord is about to pass by. So earlier I was talking about Elijah was led to this cave, and he actually ended up staying overnight in a cave. When you stay overnight in a cave, you don't want to stay in the front because it's cold outside, so you go in the back where it's dark and you can start a fire, all those things, or whatever. I've never lived in a cave before, but I watch enough Survivor shows to know that's what you do. And if I had to live in a cave, I'm pretty sure I can do it because I watch Discovery Channel. What's so interesting to me about this, though, is that God says to Elijah, hey, I'm about to pass by, but you're going to miss my presence if you stay where you are. You're going to miss when I come past the front of this cave if you're still back in the dark place. You're going to miss what I have for you. You're going to miss hearing my voice. You're going to miss these things. I want to speak to you, Elijah. You started the conversation with prayer. I'm coming to talk to you, but you first have to change where you're at in order to hear what I'm saying. And so I don't know where you are at. I don't know. Maybe you find yourself in a cave this season. 2020 was rough. I get it. We were alone for a long time. So you may find yourself in the cave of depression, you may find yourself in a cave of anxiety, you may find yourself in a cave of fear, a cave of pain, a cave of loneliness, a cave of Devonte, you don't even know what I've been going through. I can't leave the dark place because I feel tethered to it. Actually, I've been in the dark place for so long, I feel comfortable here. I've made a bed. My fire's still burning. So I can just stay right here. But can I tell you, young person? Can I tell you, student? Can I tell you, whoever's watching this, that if we want to hear the voice of God, we have to understand that. We have to get out of the dark place because he's at the front of the cave. We have to change our posture in order to hear what he's saying to us. See, because this is what I know. Your calling, your breakthrough, the relationship, the things that you're asking God for in prayer aren't going to be in the dark. In fact, I know this, that your destiny cannot be found in dark places. It can only be found in the light of Christ. It can only be found when you're saying, you know what, God, here I am. Here's my dirt. Here's my shame. Here's the thing I sinned about. Here's the guilt that I had. I'm going to leave the darkness. I'm going to leave the place of loneliness. I'm going to leave the place of anxiety. And I don't know if you're going to show up, but I know that if I just change my posture a little bit, what happens is I open myself up to the opportunity to hear the voice of God. And you may be saying, that's great, but I've been in the dark place for so long, I don't even know how to change my posture. I want to encourage you with a couple things on how to change your posture. The first one is this. You can read your Bible. You can just read your Bible. And it's hard. I know I just say read your Bible. You may have never read your Bible before, so you don't even know where to start. I would encourage you to start in the Gospels. I would encourage you to start reading about Jesus Christ, this guy who came, he lived, and he died in order for you to understand, in order for you to get the ability to say, I'm no longer tethered to the dark place. But I want the light of Christ. You can pray. You know, I've never prayed before. I don't know what it looks like. Can I just simplify what prayer is? It's not having the right words. It's not talking a whole lot. It's simply saying, hey, God, here I am. I've never done this before. I don't know what this looks like. I don't even know what I'm supposed to say. My union night, Devonte told me, if I just pray to you, if I just say, hey, God, here I am. I'm scared, I'm alone, I'm hurt, I'm in pain, I'm depressed, I don't know, but I don't want to be in the dark place anymore. God says, that's the conversation I was waiting for you to have with me. My son, my daughter, let's move you to a different part of that cave. Let's get you closer to the light of Christ. The third thing you can do to change your position is you can worship. What I love about Union Night is we worship together. We have fun. And then after this, we're going to worship. We're going to lift our hands. We're going to say, thank you, Jesus. You are great. You are amazing. I worship you. I give you everything that I have. You can come to a union night. You can get around people who are like you, your age, trying to figure out the same thing that you're trying to figure out, navigate the same life that you're trying to navigate. Get around people who are like you. The last one is this. You can join a student group. I want to encourage you. Here's why we push groups so much. It's not because our church does groups. It's not because we want to have like crazy, weird things and sit around in a circle and sing kumbaya and hold hands and snap and stuff and do weird things like that. It's because this, we truly believe that we can grow in these rows. We can learn in these rows, but we grow when we're in circles. We grow. We take the ability to get up and walk to the front of the cave in order to see the presence of the Lord. So we're going to do prayer. We're going to pray to hear God. We're going to change our posture to hear God. And lastly, point number three is this. We're going to have patience to hear God. Patience. 1 Kings 19, 11b through 12. Then a great and powerful wind tore the mountains apart, shattered the rocks before the Lord, but the Lord was not in the wind. And after the wind, there was an earthquake, but the Lord was not in the earthquake. And after the earthquake came a fire, but the Lord was not in the fire. And after the fire came a gentle whisper. I love to listen to my music loud, like so loud that my wife gets annoyed with how loud it is. Even the TV, like videos I watch on my phone while I'm on Instagram, she's like, babe, why is it so loud? Why are you doing that? It's loud. I don't know about you guys. I was with Jaden Rollins the other day. Jaden, he was driving. I don't understand how his car still has speakers. This man had the volume all the way up, and he's trying to have a conversation with me. I'm like, Jaden, I can't hear what you're saying because your music is so loud. And I love this, too. I have AirPods. Yeah, I'm going to brag a little bit. I'm like, you know, pros, pros, you know. But it's crazy. I was listening to my music loud, like I normally do, and I had this notification come from Apple. I don't know if you've ever gotten this notification before. It's a notification. It turned the volume of my music down and said, hey, you've been listening to music too loud for too long, and it's going to cause damage to your hearing. And as I thought about that, and I thought about the world that we live in, is we're so attracted to big and loud and new and amazing that it's damaging our hearing of the voice of the Lord. We've been listening to the world tell us what's cool, tell us what's amazing. Hey, you need to be an Instagram influencer. Hey, you have to have the clout. Hey, you have to do these things. And the world has become so loud that we've damaged our ears to hearing the voice of the Lord. Here's what I love about the story with Elijah. If Elijah was going to hear the voice of the Lord, he had to pray. He had to change his posture. The last thing he had to do was wait. I don't know about you guys, if mountains tore apart and then an earthquake followed that and then there was fire, I'd be like, oh yeah, that's God right there. That's gotta be God. That fire just came out of nowhere. What is happening? That's God. What I love is Elijah had the ability to say, hey, I've already been in prayer and conversation with God. And he said, If I want to hear him, I have to change my posture, which means I'm going to have to get closer to the cave, which means I'm probably going to have to lean in a little bit. So it's probably not in the wind, and he's probably not in the earthquake. I don't think he's in the fire. I'm just going to wait a little bit longer. And a gentle whisper came in and began to speak to Elijah. See, here's what we have to understand. We've become so fixated on the loud things in life that we've discredited the power of quiet. In fact, I believe it teaches us this. It teaches us that God isn't looking for us to just love the loud things in life, although he does want us to love those things. He's saying, will you be sensitive to listen to me in the quiet? Will you be sensitive to say, hey, I'm going to wait right here. He may have come in the wind. He may have come in the earthquake. And he may have come in the fire. And I know my God can do those things. But I just feel like if I just wait a little bit, maybe he'll speak directly to me. Here's what I love. When we're forced to be quiet, we have to listen to the details. We have to look for the details. We have to look for the little thing. And we wait long enough. That still small voice with pride in its tone says, I love you, son. I love you, daughter. I'm here for you. I never left you. I'll never leave you. I'll never forsake you. In fact, I've been waiting for you to start a conversation with me. And as soon as you started to pray to me and you started that conversation, I began speaking. And then as you kind of came out of that dark thing that was tying you to the sin that you felt and the guilt that you felt was leaving you out of a relationship with me, as you began to change your posture, as you began to move forward out of that dark thing, I started to come in front of that cave. And then when you had the ability to just wait for me to speak in the quiet, that's what I was looking for. So, Union students, I truly believe this. If we want to have the best year possible. If we want to leave 2020 in the past where it belongs and make 2021 our year, we're going to have to quiet the things of the world in order to hear the voice of God. Dear students, I love you so much. Can you stand wherever you are at home and turn your TV up, turn your iPad up, turn your phone up, whatever you're listening to this on, wherever you may be listening to this, whenever you listen to this. And you turn up, stand on your feet, and let's just worship the God who wants to have a conversation with us, whose presence is about to cross in front of the cave. As we posture ourselves in worship, we'll be patient to listen to him. Let's worship.
If you believe the word that was just spoken over your life today, I dare you to get yourself some room. Get yourself some room, because what God has planted in your life since you was born, it won't stop. Now, let's go! The miracles is gonna happen in your life for your family. I dare you, if you know the song, sing it with us, sing it with us, sing it with us.
Here's what I love about the presence of God. And I love about what that worship song says. It's that his presence is an open door. He's waiting for you to respond. Just in the same way that he's waiting for you to initiate conversation through prayer. He says, son, he says, daughter, here I am. I don't care about the sin. I don't care about the shame. I don't care about what you did 5 minutes ago, 5 years ago. I don't care. My presence is an open door. And I love you. And I'm here for you. And I'll never leave you, and I'll never forsake you. And I don't know where you're at in your relationship with Jesus Christ. I don't know if you've ever said yes before. I don't know if you said yes a million times to Jesus, but I want to give you an opportunity right now to say, God, I'm tired of listening to the loudness of the world. I want to be still and hear the quiet so I can be tuned in to the whisper. If that's you, I want to encourage you right now, wherever you are, whenever you watch this, you just close your eyes and pray this prayer with me. Say, God, I thank you for sending your son Jesus. I thank you that he sacrificed his life so that I may live. From this day and every day forward, I submit my life to you. I will listen for your voice. I will move with your presence, and I will posture myself in a place of patience for you. Jesus, I love you. I thank you. In your name, amen. Amen and amen. Let's give it up for everyone who said yes to Jesus. I need you to go crazy in the chat right now, because that is the best decision you could ever make. I want to encourage you, if you said yes, make sure you take out your phone right now and text I5NEWME to 97000. And some of our friends, some of our union family is going to get connected with you so we can do life together. We love you so much, union students. Hey, check out this quick video about union night next month. Intentions next month. We are going to be talking about being intentional with our relationships, our relationships with others, our relationship with ourselves, and our relationship with God. It's going to be amazing. We are going to be in person. I promise you, no snowstorm is going to stop us next month in the name of Jesus. We will be back in this building partying together. And I'm so excited to meet with you. I want to encourage you can go right now to the link in our Instagram bio and you can register to be with us in person on February 28th. It's going to be an amazing night. Union students, I love you so much. We'll see you here next month for Intentions. Love y'all.